practical physical implementation of all my artifact inventing and production of the matter to physical demonstrations. I deliberately.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help.
You've got to do it again. Extensively overriding commitment that I made before developing all my already recounted disciplines and commitments, especially to the principle of precession, thereby I gained complete release from the concept of earning a living for my family and myself, and gained as well the day practical physical implementation of all my artifact inventing and production of the matter to physical demonstration. I deliberately kept this all-important commitment to the last. If I had not come to this, it is not more effective than under suspension.
This is Edward R. Moore. We're going to talk about flying saucers. We're going to talk about them from the standpoint of reporting. Not as Canadians, not as sensations.
For the past 3 years,
a large number of plentiful sound and variety of people have been involved in this flying saucer business. Even those of us who have never seen one have been talking about them. We read about them, talk about them, wonder about these reports of strange phenomena in the sky. So almost from the start, CBS has been following the story. They have been collecting material on flying saucer observations for many months. Checking, cross-checking, trying to track down the lead, no matter how far it will be. This tonight is our report. We frankly admit that we don't know whether it's
more effective than that is mentioned. As one yet unmentioned, offensively overriding commitment I made before developing all my already counted commitments, especially in fiscal recession, thereby I gained complete relief from the concept of individual confinement. We gain as well today flexible physical implementation for my contact spending with production so that is a physical demonstration. And deliberate.
Talk about flying saucers.
about them from the standpoint of reporting, not as comedians, not as sensationalists.
Did I not come on foot? They did not come
through in my lifetime, however. It's quite possible that I might not even have the equipment. Let's do all the easy compliments, the resolutions, the justice. You have the first half of my life. 52 years of career, the orientation of my life passion. This has determined the exhaustive element of the idea of earning a living for my family, myself, while attending in college, the ecological recession, society, and simply needing material and tools, money to carry on the work. My family, my wife's family, thanks to say, I think government is touching my wife. Let's go to the high woods from time to time, accept the job, the property they got from family. And for the moment, all these friends and family, the relief and the delighted. In the instance, however, all my grand strategies, with language, and things that go wrong, still good. One reason or another, I jumped off the deep end again, recommend myself to the unfunded, comprehensive program, the solving the problems by environment, modifying artifacts, produce the most advanced scientific technology in man, and everything will go smoothly. By and large, I seem to make more mistakes than any other time on my own. Observe thereby to make ever stricter acknowledgement of the errors, and thereafter immediately set about to deal more effectively to soothe the sorrows by the acknowledgement of erroneous results. I want anybody, leader of this chronicle, to think that I'm anything other than what I am. An average, healthy human being with all the attendant reasons and vulnerabilities. What is important is the reorientation.
This is Edward R. Murrow.
Just forever, the idea of being free.
This is Edward
Murrow. More effective than under conventional circumstances. As one, as yet unmentioned, comprehensively overriding commitment that I made before developing all my already recounted disciplines and commitments, especially in the principle of recession, thereby I gained complete relief from it.
This is Edward R. Murrow. Two talkers. We're going to talk about them from the standpoint of reporting. Not as comedian,
not as professional. For the past 2 years, a large number of typical sane and reliable people have been involved in this crying session. Even those of us who have never seen my work become involved. We'll read about them, talk about them, wonder about these reports of strange phenomena in the past. So almost from the start, CBS has been charming a story. We have been collecting material and flying saucer observations for many months, checking, cross-checking, trying to track down the beach, no matter how far afield they took us. This, tonight, is our research. We frankly admit that we don't know whether flying saucers actually exist. We've never seen one. We are going to bring the facts of hand. What they are up to, we're up to you to decide. That's up to you. It all began just a little less than 3,000 years ago. The beginning in the style of the Western Rogers, occurring in which part of the country? Early in June 1947, a 3,000... This is Edward R. Murrow. We're going to talk about flying saucers. We're going to talk about things in the standpoint of reporting. Not as comedian, not as sensational. For the past 3 years, a large number of typical sane and reliable people have been involved in this flying saucer. Even those of us who have never seen one have become involved. We knew about it, talked about it, wondered about these reports of strange phenomena in China. So almost in fact, CBS has been telling the story. We've been collecting material and flying saucer observations for many months. Checking, cross-checking, trying to track down the beam, no matter how far it is. We don't know whether flying saucers actually